Flight 11 is now in its final stages, with S38 positioned for its static fire evaluation. This crucial step not only paves the way for the upcoming launch, but also aims to set a new record for flight time. During this positioning, S38 showcased some exciting improvements to its protective coating, reflecting continued progress in durability and safety measures. Simultaneously, further refinements to the Starship V3 design were unveiled, based on insights gathered from the recently relocated rear section. These updates demonstrate SpaceX's consistent progress in perfecting the next iteration of Starship. Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. As we approach the end of September, it's clear that now is the time for SpaceX to intensify efforts and finalize preparations for Flight 11. Activity at Starbase is relentless, with each action bringing the project closer to the next major milestone. After B-15's test run concluded and its return to the production facility, SpaceX immediately turned its attention to the aircraft. The aircraft's test equipment was installed, modifications were made to the launch pad, and preparations moved forward rapidly. Once everything was ready, establishing a launch schedule became the next priority. SpaceX originally aimed to lift the spacecraft between 10 p.m. on September 16 and 2 a.m. Central Time on September 17. However, this schedule was revised to occur between midnight and 4 a.m. on the 17th. Support equipment was positioned correctly as planned. The spacecraft's lifting jig headed to Mega Bay 2 late on the night of the 16th, followed quickly by the transport bay. A few hours later, S-38, the final version of the two spacecraft, headed to the first pad, where the chopstick system was prepared. By dawn on the 16th, S-38 had been lifted onto the test platform, ready for its final pre-flight testing phase. A static fire test timeframe was established, with ramp closure scheduled from 10 a.m. to 9 p.m. on September 18th, and from 7 a.m. to 4 p.m. on September 19th. Both timeframes were considered key, suggesting that SpaceX might conduct two test segments. The first will likely involve a single-engine static fire intended to verify engine reignition in space, a critical task required for upcoming missions involving orbital refueling and extended flights. The second will likely consist of a full 6-engine static fire assessment aimed at evaluating the spacecraft's power system, agility, and landing control features. This evaluation is crucial, especially considering the insights gained from the issues encountered during flights 7, 8, and 9. If all goes according to plan, the S-38 static firing operation will be completed on September 19th or 20th. After this, the vehicle will return to the manufacturing facility for inspection, payload integration, and flight termination system setup. Simultaneously, the launch pad will undergo its preparation process, which includes the removal of the ship's test system and the installation of a liner. At this point, the B-15 will be fully equipped with its hot staging ring and flight termination system, which is expected to occur between the 22nd and 28th. This timeline maintains the potential for a late September launch, although statements from Bill Gerstenmaier indicate that Flight 11 may be delayed until early October. Despite the schedule adjustments, the timing still presents an exciting opportunity. If SpaceX successfully launches before the third day, they will set a new record, taking 37 days from Flight 5 to 6. This achievement not only marks rapid progress, but also underscores the momentum gained from the success of Flight 10. As for the vehicle itself, Flight 11 will not differ significantly from Flight 10, but it does include significant upgrades. The most significant improvement focuses on the heat shield. On previous missions, some metal tiles were missing, and these gaps caused oxidation issues. For this mission, the heat shield is now fully tiled, ensuring a more comprehensive and reliable system. Furthermore, SpaceX has introduced a new wrapping method to secure the tiles and seal the gaps, which helps prevent heat and oxidizer leakage. At launch, S-38 exhibited a striking new appearance. The shielding appeared smooth and cohesive, with fewer misalignments than previous versions. Only a small portion of the nose cone still lacked a tile, which may have been intentional for testing or may have been resolved later. Overall, the strength and connections between the tiles appeared stronger than before, increasing confidence in the system's ability to withstand the extreme temperatures of re-entry. Many observers now consider S-38 to have the most advanced and reliable heat shield ever built for Starship. However, true validation will only come during flight. Flight 11 is a significant mission because it marks two contrasting milestones. This serves as the final assessment of the V2 design, paving the way for the transition to V3. At the same time, achieving success is crucial to maintain confidence, signal progress, and sustain program momentum during this critical time. The results will significantly impact the timeline and objectives of future flights. Currently, attention is focused on static firing operations. This final evaluation will determine whether Flight 11 can proceed as planned and potentially set a new record for turnaround speed. Are you ready for this challenging next phase? Show your enthusiasm by writing "Let's do it" in the comments below. Then give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel to stay up to date on SpaceX's progress in shaping the future of space exploration. SpaceX is not only preparing for the upcoming Flight 11, but is also gradually revealing various upgrades for the next generation Starship. Following the appearance of two strange tank segments at Star Factory, with one section already transported to Mega Bay, a new component has now been unveiled. This latest addition appears to be the aft segment of the spacecraft. During transport, the component flipped over, exposing the rim that houses the engine mounting ring. This section was later lifted by a crane and moved to the Sanchez area, suggesting it may be destined for scrap. However, before that happens, SpaceX has revealed some key insights into future upgrades. The most striking feature is the presence of distinctive openings in the dome area. These holes are thought to serve as mounting locations for the Raptor vacuum engines. If confirmed, this suggests the engines will be positioned directly within the liquid oxygen tank. This approach is similar to how SpaceX previously inserted grid fins directly into methane tanks, simplifying the overall design. The reasoning behind this adjustment hasn't been explained by SpaceX, but it's likely aimed at optimizing efficiency and reliability. By mounting the engines directly onto the tanks, this configuration eliminates the long propellant pipes that typically transport fuel from the tanks to the engines. These pipes are fragile components, prone to leaks or pressure issues that could lead to flight failure. Eliminating these pipes would simplify the system and reduce risk, while improving performance by more directly utilizing tank pressure to power the engines. With the introduction of this rear segment, it's increasingly clear that production of the S39, the first Starship V3, being launched soon. When that time comes, we'll finally get a full look at V3, which Musk described as a complete redesign compared to the previous V1 and V2 versions. The future of Starship is rapidly evolving, and the specific details of this new segment provide insight into the innovative steps SpaceX is preparing. So, let's stay tuned for more developments. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next one.